I've actually decided I don't want to use any paint in today's flip, but that doesn't mean it can't be colorful. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm getting started today by cleaning the piece off. It's been in my shop for a long time, so it's gathered quite a bit of dust, but then I'm going to be focusing on removing the old shellac. I believe that is what is, the finish on here is, as I showed you close-ups, I'm sure you can see that it's quite bumped and bubbled and the old finish is just destroyed, and I'm going to be removing it actually with denatured alcohol instead of trying to sand it all off, but I'll tell you a little bit more about that when we get there because I've got some cleaning to do first. As I was cleaning this, I realized that this is not connected. Looks like it was glued. Anyway, gotta fix that. Switch out my sunglasses for my safety goggles. If you have a finish that you know is shellac or you suspect is shellac, a denatured alcohol is going to be able to remove that old finish. It's a very common finish that they used on older furniture. The denatured alcohol kind of dissolves it and makes it easy to wipe off. I'm going to be using a rag, just the leftover kitchen washcloth that has been donated to my destroy pile. If you're not sure whether your old furniture has a shellac finish or a lacquer finish, if you try denatured alcohol on it and it doesn't do anything, it's probably lacquer. For that, you can try a lacquer thinner to get it off, or you can try stripping it or whatever. But if you try a lacquer thinner on shellac, also won't do you any good. So our denatured alcohol is going to break down this shellacked finish and help us remove it. But I can't open it, so I need to go get something. Alright, so pardon my muffled voice, but I do have a mask on. We're going to start out by putting some of this denatured alcohol right onto our rag and rubbing it on the surface. Denatured alcohol evaporates quite quickly, but if you let it sit on for a little bit and then come right back to it before it evaporates, you can scrub that old finish right off. Just make sure to keep your rag nice and moist. Now, most articles that I've read about using denatured alcohol to remove old shellac will recommend that you let it sit for 2 minutes before wiping it back off with a denatured alcohol soaked rag, but I did not let mine sit for 2 minutes. This is partly due to the heat that I was dealing with and partly due to my impatience. I was lucky if I let it sit for a whole minute. And did that slow me down or hurt my progress? Possibly, I'm not sure, but like I said, it was very, very warm and it was evaporating so quickly that this is the method that I took. To start with, I used a rag to wipe things on. I also used a foam brush to get it sitting on there, and then when I would go back to swipe it back, I would either use a rag or some denatured alcohol dampened paper towels. That worked well, but I went through them so quickly that it seemed quite wasteful to me, so I went back to my rags and then eventually on to steel wool, which, especially in the tougher areas, was definitely the winner. Now that the whole piece had been gone over once with the denatured alcohol and it was looking pretty good, it was time for me to tackle the giant crack in the top of the lid. Now, to get there, I was going to have to take the lid off and take it apart, and in doing so, I had to take the hinges off, which meant I got a little sidetracked and went inside and cleaned up the hinges. boiling them in water and vinegar, scrubbing them clean, and then noticing that they weren't exactly the same color. Interesting. But I'm gonna add wax over top of them and help them match just a little bit better. Somebody has tried to fix the crack in the top here before by nailing a board to the back side. And while that may have stabilized it a bit, it didn't fix my problem. So I went ahead and took the old fix off. I'm also going to remove this backing part on the lid. I've decided that I don't really want it, which means to make it disappear in the areas where it touched the top and might have had some glue on it, I'm going to have to sand down the top. That's something I was hoping to avoid, but it is at this point inevitable. I have about 3 spots on this trunk that have some sort of old paint drip on them, so I'm just going to add a little bit of stripper right over those particular places. This Howard's Feed and Wax was actually sent to me a few months back off of my Amazon wish list by a viewer, and I just wanted to say a big thank you to all of you who have sent me gifts off of my wish list. I really don't deserve it, and I'm so very humbled and thankful for it. You all have been very kind to me in the comments and in so many different areas, and I just wanted to say a big thank you to all of my viewers for every comment, every like, every coffee you've bought me, every watch that you've given me. I really do appreciate it. After I got the body all scrubbed up with my feed and wax, I realized that the top where I had pulled apart and re-glued that crack still had a few gouges in it where it didn't quite meet up, and I didn't want to leave it like that, so I'm mixing some of my sanding dust in with the glue just to help it blend a little bit better, and I'm going to be adding that into the missing areas along that crack, as well as filling in that fault line as best I can. Which of course means I have more sanding in my future, but then we will definitely be on the home stretch. I did end up using the entire can of denatured alcohol, which cost me around $10 at my Home Depot, and then about this much of the Howard's Feed and Wax, and that covered all the outside, the inside, and the upside down of this trunk. If you learned anything or liked anything in today's video, I would encourage you to hit that like button, and I would really appreciate it. I also love to hear from you down in the comments, and I do take time to read and respond to every one of them. Until next week, I'm Sarah with our furniture flipping adventure. Goodbye for now.